any of the Aishwarya, are you able to see my screen clearly and are you able to hear me clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, beta. So the tools have iron blade fixed with them. Okay, so the tools means the instruments that are used in soil, they have iron blade fixed to the wooden handle. Okay, they have the wooden handle, and to those wooden handles, iron blade is fixed. Now that iron blade has a ring in which the wooden handle is fixed. That iron blade, it is having the ring-like structure in which the wooden handle is fixed. Ring is smaller in size than the wooden handle. The size of the ring is smaller than the size of the wooden handle. So there are some tools that are used to dig the soil. That tools are basically made of iron, matlab loha, and they are fixed to the wooden handle. This iron blade, it is having one ring, and that ring is attached to the wooden handle. And actually, the size of the ring is much smaller than the wooden handle. So now we will study how we will fix that wooden handle inside the iron blade ring. Now, to fix the handle, the ring is heated. You can see these are the tools that are used in the agriculture process or to dig the soil. You can see this is the iron ring and this one is the wooden handle. Okay, the iron ring and the wooden handle. Now it is like this. Okay, this is open and this is open. Now we have to fix the wooden one and the iron one. So how we will fix it? So what you have to do is you have to heat the ring, and on heating it expands, means the size increases. The size increases on heating. When we heat the iron ring, the size increases. So now the handle moves inside the ring easily. Handle can move inside the ring easily. I will show you. See, this is the ring. Okay, its actual size is this one. Now we heated it. Okay, now we are heating with any of the size of the iron ring increases, and now we can fix the wooden handle in it very easily. Switch off your mic, whosoever it is. Now, as we heat the ring, it expands, means the size increases, and the handle fits to the ring very easy. And when the ring cools down, jab thanda ho jata hai, okay, it contracts and it fits tightly to the ring. Contract matlab, it comes back to its original. See, this is the iron ring, okay, and when we heat the ring, the size increases. When we heat the ring, the size increases, and this wooden handle can be fixed in. And as it cools down, and the ring are fitted very tightly. So in this way, we are bringing in any of the object. I will switch off. Switch off your mic, beta. Switch off your mic. Okay. So this metal, metal rim, and this is the wheel. This is the wheel. So we have to fix this metal rim in this wheel. So how we will do this? See, the metal rim is slightly smaller than the wooden wheel. You can see in your figure 6.7, the rim is smaller in size than the wheel. So how we will fix the metal rim on the wheel? We will follow the same procedure. We will heat the metal rim, and when we heat the metal rim, it expands, means the size of the rim increases. Then we fix it on the wooden wheel. As the size of the rim increases, we fix it on the wheel. And when we pour cold the rim, it contracts and it fits tightly on the wheel. The rim switch. Off your mic, beta. Switch off your mic, everyone. Ishwade, are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So now, as we fix the rim onto the wheel, what happens? It gets fixed. Now, what we will do? We will cold water on the rim. When we pour the cold water, it contracts, matlab wapis apne shape mein aa jata hai, and it fits tightly to the wheel. In this way, we can fix the metal rim on the wooden wheel. So by heating the change, we are heating and we are bringing. So what we are doing, we are heating and then we are bringing that object. So this way in which we can change. So we studied two examples. One was of the tools that we use, and the another one is the wheel and to fix the metal rim on the wheel. Okay, so now some more changes are water changes to vapor. When we heat the water by the process of evaporation, changes to the liquid state, changes to gaseous state. So this is one you can see in the picture. I will show you. See this picture, you can see what is happening. The water is changing into vapor state. This is also one example of change. This is also one example of change, means water is converting into vapors, means liquid is converting into gas. Now the next example is ice melts when heated. When we heat the ice, you can see it converts into water. Ice converts into water, means solid is changing into liquid. Solid is changing into liquid. So this is also one change. It can be called as the melting of ice. Means solid ice is converting into liquid water. Is that clear? Sneha, say yes or no, beta. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, okay. Screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now switch off your mics. So this is also one change. Now we will study some more changes. In this, we will study burning of candle. You will see in the burning of candle, what happens is two types of changes are brought. Switch off your mic. Anyone's mic is on. Switch off your mic, beta. Okay. So now you will see in this burning of candle, two types of changes are brought. One is reversible change and the another one is irreversible change. So when we burn the candle, see, burning of candle can be defined as irreversible because we can reshape the wax, but we cannot get the burnt thread of the candle back. See, this is important. The burnt thread means the wick of the candle. We cannot get back that wick or the thread in the candle. That's why burning of candle is reversible. That's why it is non-reversible or irreversible change. We'll show you the picture. See, you can see this. When we burn the candle, this thread, okay, this thread, we cannot get back the thread again. The thread, we cannot get back again. That's why burning of candle is irreversible change. We are burning the candle, and as we burn the candle, the thread, jo dhaga hota hai usme, okay, you can see this thread also burns. We cannot get back this thread again. That's why burning of candle is irreversible change. Now we will see why burning of candle is also called as reversible change. So what happens when we burn the candle? The wax is melted. Melting of wax takes place. So this melting of wax is a reversible change. This melting of wax is a reversible change. See, this wax, we can heat the wax again and it can be molded back to a candle. Means from the wax, we can get the candle again. That's why melting of wax is reversible change. Melting of wax is reversible change. So when we burn the candle, two types of changes happen. One is reversible change and the another one is irreversible change. So why it is reversible? Because the melting of wax can be reversed back. Means from the wax, we can form the candle again. That's why it is reversible change. But in case of the thread, okay, the thread that is present in the candle, we cannot get back the thread again. That's why it is known as irreversible change. See, melting of wax is a reversible change. We are melting this wax and then again we can form a candle out of it. That's why it is a reversible change. So when the question comes, what type of changes happen when you burn the candle? So what you have to write? When we burn the candle, two types of changes occur. One is reversible change and the another one is irreversible change. Then you have to explain why it is reversible and why it is reversible. Now we will see one more example. Burning of incense stick means the agarbatti. You can see the agarbatti over here. Okay, so burning of incense stick. Incense stick means agarbatti. It is irreversible change. It is irreversible change. Now, why it is irreversible? Because as the incense stick or the agarbatti burns, it produces ash. You can see it produces ash. And this ash is a new product that is formed. You all know, na? Last week I explained that in irreversible changes, new products are formed. So this ash is a new product that is formed. And from this ash, we cannot get back the incense stick again. That's why burning of agarbatti or the incense stick is irreversible change. Now you can see ash and gases are produced when we burn the incense stick. You can see these gas, you can see the gases coming out, and here you can see the ash. So ash and gases are the new products. They are new products that are formed. That's why this burning of incense stick is irreversible change. Now, the last example that we will study in this chapter is setting of curd, reversible change. Now, the milk, it changes to new substance, that is the curd. Milk is changing into curd. That's why it is known as irreversible change. Means you cannot get back the milk again from the curd. Once the curd is set from the milk, ek bar dahi jam gaya, okay, so you cannot get back the milk again. You cannot get back the milk from the curd. That's why setting of curd is irreversible change. Any change in which we cannot get back the substance, the original substance, that type of change is known as irreversible change. So setting of curd is also example of irreversible change. So these were some of the examples, means the other ways in which we can bring about the changes and whether that changes will be reversible or irreversible. We studied about that thing, this topic, in today's class. Okay. So now in this much part, if anyone is having any doubt, you can mention. Which beta, which Aishwarya, what it is reversible or irreversible, what question you asked, mark it clearly.
Ma'am, when metal ring is fixed into the cartwheel.
That is reversible beta, because again we are getting back the same size. We are getting back the same size of the iron ring. That's why it is reversible change.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Anyone is having any doubt in this much part? Now, this chapter number 6 is complete. Chapter number 6 is complete. I will be giving you 2 more minutes to clear up your doubts. Then we will start with chapter number 7. We will start with chapter number 7. If you have any doubt in this much part, you can ask me. You can message in the chat box.
I think so. Someone asked. Bhavna beta, that is the spade. The picture that you asked, it is the spade. And it is used for digging the soil. That is used for digging the soil. Okay, I think so. Now no one is having any doubt. If any having any doubt, you can mention. Okay, so now I will move on to the next chapter. That is chapter number 7. You all can take out chapter number 7 in your books. Getting to know plants. We will study about plants in this chapter. Something about nature we will study. Okay. Ishwara, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will start with chapter number 7, getting to know plants. So what we will study, getting to know plants. We will study from the name of the chapter itself. You can guess that we are going to study about plants in this chapter. So the first thing that you have to study in this chapter is what are the parts of the plant. Take out figure 7.2 in your book and mark the parts of the plant in that. You can see the parts of the plant in this picture. So the same picture is given in your book, figure 7.2. You can mark the picture in your book. You can label the parts. You can see this is the flower. This part is the fruit. This is the stem. This is the leaf. Okay? And basically these flowers, fruit, stem and leaf forms the shoot system. So the parts of the plant that are above the ground, they form the shoot system. So flowers, fruit, stem and leaf. They forms the shoot system of the plant as they are present above the ground level. Now below the ground is the root system, means roots of the plant are present below the ground. Roots of the plant are present below the ground. Mark this diagram in your book. Flowers, fruit, stem, leaves, and the roots. These parts basically you have to mark. Now we are moving to next slide. The first topic in this chapter is herbs, shrubs, and trees. So how we will get to know that whether that plant is a herb, shrub, or a tree. So what all you have to look for? See, the first thing that mainly we have to look for is the stem and the branches of various kinds of plants. By looking at the stem and the branches, we get to know what these plants are, whether they are herbs, whether they are shrubs or trees. So what you will observe, that some plants are much smaller than you. Some of the height of some of the plants are very short. And in some cases, the plants are about your size. Means your size and the height of the plant is near about same. And the next thing that you will observe is some of the plants are much taller than you. They are big heighted. They are very tall. So these three observations you will come across. Some of the plants are very small. Some of the plants are about your size. And some of the plants are very taller. They are very taller. So now what
or else you have to look for. So what you have to look for is when you feel the stem of various plants. So you have to touch the stem of the plants, and what all you will see? You will see that some stems are tender. Tender means weak. Some stems are very soft. You can say tender means soft or weak. Some stems are hard. When you touch the stem, some are hard, some are soft. Some stems can be bent. You can easily bend the stem of some of the plants. Some stems do not break. Means the breaking of the stem is not easy in case of some of the plants. And in some of the stems, they are very thick. So these are the observations that you will come across when you will feel the stem of various plants. What all you will see? They are soft, they are hard, they can be bent, they cannot break, and some of them are very thick. So what all you studied? You studied that in some cases the plants are very small. In some cases they are about your height, and in some cases they are very tall. And when you feel the stem of various plants, what you will see, some of these stems are very soft, means tender. Some of these stems are very hard. Some of these stems can be bent easily, means more dhor sakte usko easily, okay? And some of these stems, they do not break, means they are not easily broken. Some of these stems are very thick. Now, on the basis of these observations, you will categorize the plants in three categories. You will categorize the plants in three categories that are herbs, shrubs, and trees. Herbs, shrubs, and trees. Okay, now we studied about stem. Now, when we will look at the branches, what we will see that some branches grow close to the ground. In some of the plants, the branches, they grow very close to the ground. And in some of the cases, the branches grow higher up on the stem. Okay, so this will come in case of branches. Am I audible to you all, Sneha or
yes.
Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
You are able to see the screen clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, beta. Now, on the basis of these categories that are shown by the stem and the branches, the characters that are shown by the stem and the branches, means they are soft, stems are soft, they are thick, they are hard, branches, they grow closer to the ground or they grow higher on the stem. We categorize the plants in three categories: herbs, shrubs, and trees. Now we will study what actually these types of plants are. The first that we will study is herbs. So what are the characteristics of herbs, or what are the characters shown by herbs? So the plants with green and tender stem. The plants with green and tender stem. Tender means soft. The plants that with green and tender stem are called herbs. They are usually short. Short spelling is wrong. Short. They are usually short, means they are short-heighted and may not have many branches. So these are the characters that are shown by herbs. They are green. They have soft stem. They are short-heighted and they may not have many branches. Now, these are the herbs, characteristics of herbs. The plants with green and tender stem are called as herbs. They are short-heighted, they may not have many branches. And the most important feature of herbs is that they are used for food, for flavoring, for medicine, and for perfume. So some of the herbs we use for food, some for flavoring, giving the taste in the food. Some are used as medicines, and some are used as perfume, means they give fragrance, they give smell. Now we will study some of the examples of herbs. If you want to note down these examples, you can note down in your book itself. Okay, that will be easier for you. So the first example is basil or tulsi. So the most common example of herb is tulsi. In English, we call tulsi as basil. Is the screen clear? Aishwarya or Sneha, is the screen clear?
Ma'am, clear.
Okay. You can note down these examples in your copy, everyone. So, this tulsi, it is one of the example of herb. And you all know that this tulsi, it is used for medicines. This tulsi is used for medicine. It has medicinal properties in it. Now, the next example is mint or pudina. This is also used as flavoring agent. When we need to add some flavor to the food, we add pudina. In English, we call pudina as mint. So, this is the second example of herb. Pudina is the second example of herb. The first example is tulsi, second is pudina. Now the next example is coriander. In Hindi, we call coriander as dhania. Okay, this is also used as food. This is also used as food and also for flavor. We add dhania for flavor. So this is the third example of herb. Tulsi, pudina, dhania means basil, mint, coriander. Now the next example is bay leaf. You all know, if you will ask your mother, tej patta, what tej patta is. In Hindi, that is called as bay leaf. And it is the flavoring agent. It is used in garam masala that you add in your food. This tej patta is one of the ingredient that we add in garam masala. So this is also example of herb. So the four examples that we study are tulsi, pudina, coriander means dhania, and bay leaf. These are the four common example of herbs. Note down these in your books or copies anywhere. Now, the next type of plant is shrubs. So now, what are the characters of shrubs? So the plants that develop branches near the base of the stem are called as shrubs. So the plants in which the branches arise from the base of the stem, they are known as shrubs. The stem is hard. In case of herbs, the stem was very soft. But in case of shrubs, the stem is hard, but it is not very thick. Beta, switch off your mic. Okay. So these types of plants are called as shrubs. So the plants in which the branches arise near the base of the stem are known as shrubs. And the stem is hard, but it is not very thick.
These types of plants are called as shrubs. Now, see, you can see these shrubs. One example of shrub is given. The area that is cultivated with shrubs, that is known as shrubbery. Is known as shrubbery, means in a garden or in a playground where all kinds of shrubs are grown, that area is known as shrubbery. Now we will study some of the examples of shrubs. You can note down these examples. Switch off your mic, beta. Now we will study some examples of shrubs. Note down in your book or copy. Rose shrub means rose is one of the example of shrub. The first example is rose. You can see it is very bushy. The rose plant is very bushy. Bahut ghana hota hai. Okay, that's why it is known as shrub. And the branches, they arise from the base of the stem. You can see this beautiful rose flower. Okay, so rose is the example of shrub. The next example is hibiscus, China rose or jasmine. Jasmine ka phool, you commonly call it as jasmine ka phool, that we use in prayers. In puja and all, we use this jasmine ka phool. In English, you call this as China rose or hibiscus. So this is the second example of shrub. You can see this flower very clearly. So this is the second example of shrub, hibiscus plant. It is the example of shrub. So two examples that we studied of shrub are rose and hibiscus. Now the third example is sunflower. So sunflower is also example of shrub. Sunflower, the third example of shrub is sunflower. First is rose, second is hibiscus, and the third one is sunflower. Now the fourth example is cotton. Cotton plant is also example of shrub. You can note down these examples in your book. Now we will study the third category of plant, that is trees. So we some plants already tall and have hard and thick stem. So the trees, they have very hard and very thick stem. And the stems have the branches in the upper part of the stem. Means the branches, they grow in the upper part of the stem. Such plants are called as trees. Such plants are called as trees. Now the examples we will study of trees are mango tree. Mango tree is the first example of trees. You can see that stem is very thick and very hard, and it is mostly brown in color. It is very thick and it is very hard. And you can see these branches, they arise on the top of the stem. The branches arise at the top of the stem. The next example that we will study is banyan tree. You can see such a huge banyan tree it is. So this is the second example of trees. Now the third is coconut tree. The third example is coconut tree. You can see this is the stem. It is very thick and very hard.
and the branches are coming arising at the top part of the stem. So this is the example of tree, the third example of tree. So the herbs, they have soft stem. And switch off your mic. Who's this one? Switch off your mic.
Well, Akshat Srivastav.
Akshat, switch off your mic, beta. Okay, so herbs we studied about.
Sorry, ma'am, by mistake.
Okay. In herbs, they have soft stem and they are green in color. Okay, examples of herb, tulsi, pudina, coriander. These are the examples of herbs. In case of shrubs, the branches, they arise from the base of the stem and they are hard. Examples, rose, sunflower, hibiscus. In case of trees, the stems are very hard and thick. And the branches arise from the top of the stem. The examples are mango, banyan, coconut, and any tree you know, you can give the example. Now, this much part is clear or not? If having any doubt, you can mention in the chat box. Yes, at that time, spinach is, it is a herb. Spinach is a herb. Sanskriti, if you are not able to hear, when I share the video with you, that time you can hear it clearly. Spinach is a herb. And then the mango sapling, yes, at this smaller stage, you can call it. Now, if having any more doubt, you can mention. And now, students, how many students have joined? Okay. So now, in the chat box, I'm sharing one link with you all. And that link you will open and you will mark the attendance in that link. Just a minute. I'm sharing one link with you all.
Ma'am, but in mine, there is no chat box.
Where were you when I explained that how you can see the chat box? See, I have shared one link. You can open that link and you can see Shauradeep.